Hello, in this video I will show you how to install and get started with Rust on Windows. While this video was recorded on a Windows 11 machine, it should work the same on a Windows 10 computer. In the second part of the video, I will show you how to create a new project using Cargo and how to run it. In the third part, we will install Visual Studio Code and use it as a Rust IDE to build, run and debug a simple program. Software evolves and things that worked at the time of this recording may not work in a few months or in a few years. Please check the video description for updates and corrections. Open your web browser and search for Rust App. This is the Rust installer. On the Rust App webpage, download the Windows installer. Normally the page should detect that you are on a Windows machine and offer you the Windows executable of Rust App. Once the download has finished, start the installer. On Windows, Rust needs the Microsoft Linker, which is available in Visual Studio 2022 or in the Visual Studio 2022 Build Tools. Rust App will check and if it can't find one of the above, it will offer to download and start the installation for you. As you can see, on my machine, Rust App can't find the Microsoft Linker or Build Tools, so it gives me the option to install it. If you already have Visual Studio installed, you should now see this message. If, like me, you don't have Visual Studio installed, write one and press Enter. Once the Visual Studio installer starts, you can safely accept the proposed defaults. At this point, Visual Studio is installed. Once you close it, Rust App will go to the next installation step. Choose one again and proceed with the installation. The installation is finished. Press Enter to continue. Next, I will show you how to create and run a Hello World project. Open a terminal. In order to create a new project, write cargo new hello. Next, cd inside the hello folder. If you run ls inside, you should see the content of the folder. To build and run the generated code, write cargo run. As you can see, hello world was printed on the screen. The generated code is inside the src folder. If you want to see it, write type src/main.rs and press Enter. This should show the content of the file main.rs. Optionally, you can open the file in Notepad and do a small modification to the message. Save and close Notepad. Run the code again to see the message with the previous modification. Write exit in order to leave the terminal. As promised, now I will show you how to use Visual Studio Code to build and debug Rust programs. Open a browser and search for Visual Studio Code. Download and start the installer. Accept the license agreement and press Next. Now, make sure to select the two Add Open with Code options. While not essential, this will make your life easier in the long run. Once finished, press Next. Press Finish. This will also launch VS Code. Now, I want to show you how to start VS Code from the Windows terminal and load an existing Rust project. Open your terminal and cd to where you previously created the Hello project. Make sure you are in the Hello folder and write code space dot and press Enter. This should start VS Code and load the current folder. On the left panel of VS Code, you can see the content of the Hello project. Open src and click on main.rs to see the content of the file. Next, we are going to install an extension that will let us build and run projects directly from VS Code. Click on the Extensions button. Write Rust in the search box. Now, make sure that you select Rust Analyzer and press the Install button. Done. Now, close the Rust Analyzer tab and click on the first button from left to see the project content again. If you look carefully, once you click on main.rs, there are two new buttons, Run and Debug. Press the Run button to build and run the program. Now, let's add two variables to the code and print their sum. Press Run again. If we want to be able to debug Rust programs from VS Code, we need to install another extension. Press the Extensions button and search for C++. Make sure to select the C++ extension from Microsoft. Now, press Install. Close the Extension tab and go to the Rust code again. You can click on the left side of the line numbers to add a breakpoint. Let's put a breakpoint on line 2 of our program. Now, press the Debug button. The debugger should start and it will stop the program execution on line 2. You can use the curved arrow button to step one instruction. Let's step through lines 2 and 3. If you go to the bottom line of the debug console, you can use the declared variables. For example, you can add them, divide them, and so on. When you are done, you can press the small top triangle to run the program to the end. If you want more Rust-related tutorials, let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching and please like, share and subscribe.